In Swift, structs are much more powerful than in other languages. Their capabilities approach those of classes. In addition to their own properties, they can also have their own methods and can expand functionality through extensions and protocols. Let's take a look at a couple of examples. Here's a struct called PictureFrame. It has three stored properties, width, height, and thickness, and one computed property, area. As with enumerations, structs can have customized init methods, but they also come with automatically generated member-wise initializers, like this one here. In this line of code, I'm initializing a 10x8 picture frame with a thickness of 1.5. And this is how I access the computed property, area, and up here you can see the area property's custom getter. Here's another example. This beer struct has three stored properties, style, percent alcohol, and an international cheers dictionary. Cheers dict is a type property. It also has a computed property, suggested volume per serving. The volume per serving goes down as the alcohol percentage goes up. Some of the Belgian beers at the pub around the corner from my house are super strong. If I was drinking whole pints of those, I might be in trouble. The beer struct also has its own type method, called cheers. It takes in a language and prints out a phrase to toast with in that language. And this is what initialization looks like for the beer struct. Again, I'm using the automatically generated member-wise initializer to set our style and percent alcohol properties. And here in the sidebar, you can see that a lager with 6% alcohol has been instantiated. As usual, we can access the computed property suggested volume per serving with dot syntax. Now I want to open up the console for a second so we can see our results. Remember that because cheers is a type method, we call it on the struct itself. So we call it on beer. And then let's pick a language we want to toast in. Let's toast in Japanese. And then we can look over in our console and see kanpai.